And what the menu labeling regulation in King County does is it requires all chain restaurants that have 20 or more locations nationally and gross sales more than $1 million to post information at their restaurants about the nutritional content of their foods. Particularly what it does is for calories, it requires them to post them either on a menu board, if they're a fast food kind of place, or in their menu. Or they also have options for alternatives like posters, although most folks went for menus and menu boards. It also requires to have available information on site about saturated fat, sodium, and carbohydrates, but not necessarily posted directly on the menu or the menu board.
So before the regulation, we went to 50 different establishments that were to be regulated and got receipts from about 50 people at each of those establishments. So when they walked in the door, we asked them whether they're interested in participating. If they were, to collect their receipt, and we would talk to them after they ate. We did that again in 50 places, 50 people in each place, got about 2,500 receipts, and then did that again about 5 months after the regulation went into place. So the regulation started in January 2009. The first follow-up was in spring, kind of April, May 2010. Sorry, 2009. But then we actually went back to folks again in spring 2010. So we have information from before the regulation, kind of a near post, 4 or 5 months after the regulation, and then a year and a half after the regulation. And we're excited about that because and funding through HER allowed us to collect this data over time in ways that other prior studies haven't been able to do yet.
We found there was about a 46 calorie reduction between time before the regulation and then 18 months approximately afterwards. Now, while 46 calories might seem like a small number, it actually, from a public health perspective, is actually quite a large reduction in calories when you consider that happening across large populations and affecting many, many people. 4 people reported about 12% of them said they were aware of nutrition information at their restaurants. That went up to about 50-55% afterwards, and it increased rapidly in our first wave post, meaning 2 or 4 or 5 months afterwards, and then it remained pretty steady at that rate out to a year and a half out. We also found pretty much at all 3 waves where we collected data, about a third of the people who were aware of it said they actually used the information to inform their choice and make their choice of what they ordered. Among the people who actually say they use the labels, the calorie decrease was more like 100 to 200 calories compared to the average over the whole population of about 46.
So in order to sample these restaurants, we actually separated the county into kind of low and high income, and half of our establishments were in more lower income, more ethnically diverse neighborhoods. We didn't see much of a difference in kind of that long-term effect. We saw a decrease in calories in the low-income areas and high-diverse, and we saw a decrease in calories in the higher-income areas. So our concern was unfounded, thankfully, that we wouldn't see an effect in more low-income, high-diverse places.
One is that people will see the menu label and say, oh my God, this is not healthy food for me, and they'll stop patronizing those restaurants. So we are actually surveying folks now to figure out how frequently they ate in a fast food restaurant in the past week, and we'll analyze those time trends. The other thing that we'd be very interested to follow up on is, have the items on the menu changed over time? So when you're forced to kind of reveal what the nutritional content is, does that lead you to reformulate to bring the calorie count down and the sodium level down? So we're actually systematically studying that, and we'll have results in that, and probably 3-4 months about, was there a systematic change in any of the items displayed on the menus? So there are a couple of issues that our study and the work of others have raised for rolling out the federal menu labeling regulations. One of the issues that's come to the top has been, how do you present the information on a menu or a menu board in a way that a consumer can interpret it and use that to make an informed choice? So many of the sites that have menu labeling in place already have issued a daily caloric intake statement, about 2,000 calories a day for the average person, so that you can put the 1,000 calories you see on the sandwich or the burger in the context of what you should be eating in a day. The challenge with that is that 2,000 is an average, and if you're young, you probably need less. If you're very physically active, you can probably eat more. If you have certain, if you're trying to lose weight or already overweight, you should probably be eating less. So there are real challenges in presenting this information effectively to the FDA. So our recommendation is that there needs to be some market research, basically, or formative research done by the FDA to figure out what's the most efficient way and effective way to present this information to consumers.
I mean, I think the other thing that, and Jim, you already mentioned this, but one thing we heard from our focus groups was folks that said they saw the information, but they didn't have more helpful choices to make. So if you're in an establishment that doesn't have very helpful choices, so if there's some way that the federal reg can help restaurants identify more helpful choices, even if they're only a handful, that might be quite helpful.